Asteroids are the leftover rocks that neither take part in the making of the planet, nor they fuse together and grow large enough to become a planet. They have been floating in space since the birth of our solar system and are about 4.6 billion years old. They are also called minor planets as they revolve around the sun like planets but are way smaller. Their size varies from a few feet to 1000 km across. Asteroids that are larger in size are called planetoids, whereas asteroids that are smaller than 1 meter are called meteoroid. On the 1st of January 1801, an Italian astronomer and mathematician Giuseppe Piazzi discovered the first asteroid orbiting between Mars and Jupiter. It was named Ceres after the Sicilian goddess of grain. In the next few years, more asteroids were discovered and named Pallas, Vesta and Juno. Till now, over 150 million asteroids have been found orbiting within the inner solar system. Asteroid shapes are highly irregular and covered with impact craters. Some of the largest asteroids have got enough gravity which pulls them into a spherical shape and is massive and large enough to be classified as a dwarf planet, for example Ceres and Hygieia. Some asteroids have moons, some are also found in the double and triple system. Based on their orbits, asteroids are classified into three types: main asteroid belt, Trojans and near-earth asteroids. The main asteroid belt contains millions of asteroids that orbit between Mars and Jupiter, and their total mass is only 4% of that of the Moon. These small bodies occasionally collide with each other and get deflected from their original path, which brings them relatively close to the Earth. These asteroids whose orbital distance are below 1.3 astronomical unit fall under the category of near-Earth asteroid. Another reason for their migration to the inner solar system is due to the influence of Jupiter's gravity and occasional close encounters with Mars. There are over 20,000 near-Earth asteroids. If a near-Earth object is larger than 140 meters and their orbit intersects the Earth orbit, it is considered as a potentially hazardous object. There are more than 1,500 such objects discovered. Apollo asteroid 1999 GM8 is likely the largest known potentially hazardous object with a mean diameter of 7 km. Even an asteroid as small as 35 meters can destroy an entire city. Scientists found evidence of a huge asteroid impact 65 million years ago at the Yucatán Peninsula in Mexico. It is believed that this event is responsible for the extinction of dinosaurs. The estimated size of this deadly asteroid was as big as Mount Everest. On impact, it created a 300 km wide crater by vaporizing the Earth crust. The crater is known as Chicxulub crater as its center is located near the town of Chicxulub. The amount of energy produced at the time of impact was equivalent to 100 trillion tons of TNT. It is estimated that the impact explosion was equivalent to billions of atomic bombs detonated simultaneously. The ejected rocks and debris skyrockets at a speed greater than the speed of sound and goes beyond the Earth's atmosphere. These trillions of pieces of Earth's crust wander in space, crashing on the Moon and other planets and remaining fall back towards creating a world-level devastation. Although Chicxulub asteroid impact strongly supports the impact hypothesis, some scientists believe in other factors such as volcanic eruptions, sea level change, climate change and more. Asteroids that share the orbit of Jupiter and other planets are called Trojan asteroids. They do not collide with the planet as they gather around two special places in the orbit called the L4 and L5 Lagrange points. To understand this, we have to learn about these points. Lagrange points are the points located around the large orbiting system such as Sun and Earth, where a smaller object such as spacecraft or asteroids will maintain its stable position. These locations are stable because at these points, the gravitational, centripetal and Coriolis force act in such a way that causes the small object to maintain a stable position and prevent it from moving to a separate orbit. Lagrange points are named in honor of Italian-French mathematician Joseph Louis Lagrange. The mathematical problem known as the general three-body problem was considered by Lagrange in his prize-winning paper in 1772. There are 5 Lagrange points. Out of 5, 3 are along the line of 2 large bodies called L1, L2 and L3 and are less stable points. The other 2, L4 and L5, are more stable and lie 60 degrees ahead and behind the planet. L4 and L5 form the peak of 2 equilateral triangles that have the large masses at their vertices. L4 leads the orbit and L5 follows it. These points are the best places for spacecraft to park. At the L1 point, we get an uninterrupted view of the Sun, and it is currently occupied by the Solar and Heliospheric Observatory and the Deep Space Climate Observatory. At the L2 point of the Earth-Sun system, the WMS spacecraft was deployed. After that Planck, and in the future, this place will be occupied by James Webb Space Telescope. The L3 point lies behind the sun and is hidden from view all the time. Due to this reason, scientists are unable to utilize this point. L4 and L5 points are more stable, and objects found orbiting these locations are termed as Trojans. The first Jupiter Trojan was discovered by German astronomer Max Wolf in 1906. This minor planet was designated Achilles after a legendary hero from Greek. It is believed to be as many Jupiter Trojans as there are asteroids in the main asteroid belt. In 2010, NASA's WISE telescope confirmed the first Trojan asteroid, 2010 TK7, at L4 point of Earth's Sun system. It is estimated to be around 150 to 550 meters across. Trojan asteroids are also found sharing the orbits of Mars and Neptune. Based on the composition, asteroids are broadly classified into three basic types: C-type, S-type, and M-type. C-type or carbonaceous asteroids are made of a large amount of carbon, including rocks and minerals. These asteroids are the most common and constitute 75% of the total number of known asteroids. Due to the abundance of carbon, C-type asteroids are darker in color. Large quantities of these asteroids are located in the outer region of the asteroid belt. Hygieia is an example of a C-type asteroid. S-type or siliceous asteroids are primarily made of silica or silicon dioxide and nickel iron. 17% of total known asteroids are S-type, making it the second most common asteroids after C-type. They are moderately brighter and mostly found in the inner part of the asteroid belt. Juno, Iris are some examples of S-type asteroids. M-type or metallic asteroids are made up mostly of nickel iron, either pure or mixed with a small amount of stone. These type of asteroids are found in the middle region of the asteroid belt. Cleopatra, Lutetia, and Psyche are some examples of M-type asteroids. When a meteorite enters the Earth's atmosphere and completely vaporizes due to the aerodynamic heating, it is called a meteor, commonly known as a shooting star. On the contrary, if it survives and lands on the Earth, then it is called a meteorite. In the coming month, on 29 April 2020, a potentially hazardous asteroid OR2 will pass very close, that is 6 million km away from the Earth. Its size is estimated to be around 4 km. On Friday the 13th, 2029, a huge asteroid Apophis will fly only 31,000 km away from the Earth's surface. Its size is around 340 meters across. Scientists are gearing up to study this asteroid as it's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to witness the asteroid that comes as close as this one. I hope you learned something new from the video. Thanks for like, share, comment, and subscribe. I will see you next time. Thanks for watching.